Hi all, today we learn how to do this beautiful nib painting. For this, materials required are designer nibs. You get such designer nibs in the market. One is sharp tip and one is round tip. Brushes, tissue paper, velvet cloth board. I have made this velvet cloth board by sticking it onto a cardboard like this kind of a cardboard. I'll give a link on how to make this velvet board. Once I've stuck the velvet cloth, it looked like this. Tracing design, preferably a floral design. White carbon because the board is black. Palette. Oil paints. Pencil for tracing the design. Now, let's begin making this beautiful nib painting. First, you have to start tracing the design onto the velvet board. Place the design on the velvet board like this. And underneath the design, keep the carbon paper. Like this. Once you have placed the carbon paper, go ahead and trace the design very carefully and neatly with all the detailing of leaves and flowers. Do the tracing. So I'll meet you guys at the end of the tracing. So this is how the completed design will look on the velvet board. So once this has been done, we'll start painting. So I've taken white and crimson red onto my palette. I'll be mixing both these colors to make a beautiful shade of pink, light pink. Since the board is dark, it would be better if you paint light color flowers, so that it will look beautiful in the dark board. So I've done this by mixing white and crimson. I've made a lighter shade of pink and then I'm going to start painting the flower. So as you can see, I'm going to paint this flower. You'll need to do a thick coat of paint because once the nibbing is done and the paint dries, the nibbing should be visible. If you do a very thin coat, the nibbing won't be clear and visible. So this is how the completed flower will look like. Hope you guys can see. Now I'll take little bit of white and do shading. As you can see, I'm doing shading here and there. Little bit of white. I'm using 000 brush for doing this. I am blending. Now, this is how your flower will look after shading. We'll start with the nibbing process. So this is the nib which I am going to use. Now, start making lines from one direction, some random lines. This is called nibbing. You have to do in the back side of the nib. As you can see, you have to keep doing like this strokes. Hope you can see. So random lines. Keep cleaning your nib because when you're doing nibbing, the excess paint is coming out. So you have to keep cleaning your nib. So in the same direction, random strokes for each petal. Hope you guys can see. This is how the nibbing is done. Now I'll show you how to do the bud. For bud, we'll mix little bit of crimson and make it a little darker shade. You can see I'm mixing a bit of crimson to the pink, lighter version, and then I'm going to paint the bud. You'll need to take a lot of paint and I'll paint these buds. So we'll start doing the nibbing. You have to do in the direction of the bud. See, like this, random lines here and there. Hope you guys can see. Like this. Now you have to complete all the flowers in the same method. Flowers and buds in the same method. This is how the design will look after completion. I've completed almost all the pink flowers. You can see how beautiful and vibrant it is looking. So we'll start with leaves. For leaves, I am using green. I'll use light green. And some yellow. I'll be using this shade of yellow. A little bit of yellow. This is not absolute necessary, but I'm just showing you how shading can be done. So now take green and start painting the leaves. I'll start by showing this particular leaf. Like this, you have to paint the leaves. Hope you can see. This is how the leaf will look. You have to do all the leaves in the same way. Now I'll take little bit of yellow. This is optional, and do a shading. Since this is a small leaf, the shading is not that visible, but when you're doing a large leaf, you can very clearly give a shading. It looks very beautiful. So I've done light shading with yellow. So once we have done this, we'll start doing the nibbing. The same nib we are using, pointed one. For leaf, we'll start by drawing a line in the center of the leaf, in which direction that leaf is, we have to draw a line. Once you have drawn that line, slanting lines here and there on both the directions and both the sides, like here and there, some slanting lines. Hope you guys can see the leaf. I'll meet you guys after doing all the leaves. So we have completed all the leaves. As you can see, I've done all painting for all the leaves. Now we will do the stem. For the stem, even same way, you have to take green. You have to apply a thick coat of paint, because once the nibbing is done and the paint dries, the nibbing should be visible. So you have to do like this. Hope you guys can see, a thick coat of paint. Very thick coat of paint. Don't worry, you can paint and then do the nibbing, because oil paint doesn't dry very easily. It takes time for oil paint to dry. So I've done painting for all the leaves, and now I'm going to do the nibbing. I'll show you how nibbing is done for this big leaf. Once again, draw a line in the center of the leaf and slanting lines randomly here and there on both the sides of the leaves. Here and there, some slanting lines. Hope you can see. The same method how we did for small leaf. Random lines here and there. Now we'll do the nibbing for the stem. In the same way, in the direction of the stem, you have to do random lines here and there. You have to remember, you have to do in the direction of the leaf or stem or flower. Random lines here and there. So we've completed the nibbing. Now you have to do the nibbing for all the rest of the leaves. I'll meet you guys once done. This is how the design will look like after completing pink flowers and the leaves. Now we'll start using the designer tip nib. This is how the nib will look like. It will have a round tip. You can see very clearly that it's a round tip. We'll start making flowers using purple and white. We'll make a beautiful shade by mixing purple and white. And I've taken white and then purple. I'll mix these two colors to make a beautiful shade of light purple. Once the mixing has been done, you have to start spreading your paint like this. You have to keep spreading it like this. Hope you can see. Once you have done this, you have to spread the paint like this. This is done so that the nib can be easily loaded. So now take the nib backside. You can see the round tip. Hope you can see the round tip. You have to load the paint here. Now take the designer nib and start loading your nib like this by pressing onto the paint. Hope you can see clearly what I am doing. See, the nib is loaded. Now if there is some paint in the tip, you just can remove it by like this. Now where you need these small flowers, you have to place your nib. For each petal, you have to keep loading the nib. Now press and just slightly. We've made one petal. Hope you can see. Once again, you have to load your nib like this. And place another petal next to the previous petal. See, like this. So for each petal, we have to load the brush. Once again, we have done the loading. We'll place the petal, third petal. Same way, we'll make a 5-petal flower. Hope you can see clearly. So this is how your flower will look like. Now I'll show you another method for making this flower. First, load your nib with purple, light shade of purple. Once you've loaded this, little bit of white you have to load in the tip. This is two shaded flower which we are going to make. Now place this onto your board like this. Press and pull. You have done one petal. Hope you can see the shading. In the tip it is white and then purple. Repeat the same technique to make a 5-petal flower. See? Place it on the board like this. Press and pull. You've done another petal. Hope you guys can see how I'm making these petals. So I'll catch you guys once this flower is being done. This is how the flower will look like. Hope you can see. Now we will start doing the center for all these flowers. For this, I am going to use a shade of yellow. By using a brush, I am going to fill the center for all these flowers like this. Once you have filled the center, you can do the nibbing. Once again, the nibbing is just random lines here and there. In one direction, random lines here and there. Hope you can see very clearly. Now I'll meet you guys after completing the whole painting. This is how the completed nib painting work will look like. If you need, you can add some random flowers here and there. Hope you can see the nibbing very clearly. Hope you all will try to make a beautiful nib painting at your home. This is very simple and easy to make. So meet you guys very soon in yet another video. Thanks for watching.